have you done with your hand?
Yeah.
What have you done with your hands? Some good, some bad. But what have you done with your hands? Let me affirm this to you today. We have these hands to reach others as healing hands. These hands, your hands, look at them, y'all, because they ain't going to look the same after the day. Those hands are anointed. Those hands will break down walls. Those hands will open up doors for those who are connected to you and those who don't even know you. Those hands will set the captives free. Those hands will clothe the naked. Those hands will heal the sick. Those hands will raise the dead. And those hands will cast out demons. Those hands will give God glory. Those hands will give God praise. Those hands will give God celebration. Those hands will give God adoration. Those hands will give God jubilation. The power is in our hands. The power is in our hands. Let us use our hands for healing with our cute little selves. Let us be an extension of what God has called us to be in this last and evil day. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Yes.
Hallelujah. Thank you, God. Thank you, God.
I know it's not a popular message, but when I read this story, I couldn't help but think about the fact that in the hustle and bustle, that's why I love God even more on today. I saw in the story how Jesus was hustling. He was preaching. He was teaching. He was busy, just like me and you. But there was a need, and he stopped, and he went to the house. He didn't say, well, y'all need to bring him over here. No, he went to the house. And he didn't have to do a whole lot. He didn't have to, he just did this. He just reached out his hand. So my question to you today is, has God, has he ever come to you with his hand and just reached out his hand in your life? Raise your hand. Come on, don't lie to me. Tell me. Has he done it for you? Has he done it for you? Has he done it for you? Has he just stretched out his hand? Reached out his hand in your life. You've experienced God's goodness, God's keeping power, his mercy, his grace, his favor, his healing. Been on the sick bed, didn't know how you were going to get well, but somehow God came. And it might be through a person, through a doctor, or somebody, but somebody came and they just did this right here. And look, what I love about the scripture is that after he reached out his hand, oh my God, mother didn't lay there. Mother did not lay there and say, Lord, I've been so sick. She won't complain. She won't. No. Read the scripture. What did she do? She got up. And you know, for a woman to get off her sick bed and go and cook, healing took place. But what I love about it is that.
Come on
here.
Amen.
My God.
Y'all, I wonder if y'all got it. Because y'all, I was waiting for somebody to yell it out. She received her healing, but she got up and she served. Come on with me. She got up and she served. She served the man of God. Cooked him some fried chicken. And those on the diet, she had some baked for him and some green beans and some potatoes and some cornbread and some sweet tea. She got in the kitchen. She cooked for the men of God. She served them. So I said to myself, I said, okay, Lord, I hear what you're saying. So help me understand. I talk to God like this. I said, help me understand something. She received her healing. She went and she served. Help me understand why in the body of Christ, we have an issue with serving.
Come on, yeah.
Why do we have an issue with serving? What is that about?
My God, you're talking.
And y'all, God talking to me real clear. You know what he told me? And I ain't making this up. He said, because they have not truly come in contact with my hand.
Yes.
They haven't experienced my anointing and my power. They have a form of godliness, but they deny the power thereof. There is no way that you can experience God touching your life and you not feel compelled to get up off of your bed and go and serve. Church, do an assessment.
Come on, Lord, help.
And if you see somebody who ain't serving, pray.
Yes,
pray that they truly come in contact with the power of God.
Yes,
pray that they truly have an encounter with Him.
Truly.
Because it's hard to come in contact with Him and not ever be the same.
That's right.
Oh my God. It's so clear. We are so driven in our society where we want the next hottest thing, the next brightest thing, someone that can say it sweet and put a lot of twists and words. God said, tell my people I'm available to heal them.
Yes, God.
And when I put my hand, this is God talking. He put his hand in your hands. There's nothing that you cannot do. There's nothing that he won't bless you with. Giving God a yes, being obedient and walking out the things that God has called you to do in this season. There's nothing that you can't do. But we got to be willing to receive his healing. Amen? I'm going to extend an invitation at this time for anyone who'd like to come for prayer.